Back in 1961, Ford bought Philco and effectively entered the home entertainment and appliance industry. Philco started up in 1892, although products with the Philco name first appeared in 1919. Over time, they developed many product lines such as batteries, radios, televisions, and by 1961 they were selling air conditioners, washing machines, and refrigerators too. But financially, they weren't doing so well. Ford purchased Philco and by 1966 had rebranded the company as Philco Ford. As well as continuing to develop home appliances and entertainment systems, Philco Ford also became a player in many other areas of electronics, including satellites, and has a real claim to fame with the designers and builders of Mission Control in Houston. In 1974, Ford started to break the group up, getting rid of the consumer electronics division, while other parts of the company went on to have new names such as Ford Aerospace and Aeroneutronic, and Philco itself became a non-Ford brand. But from 1966 to 1974, you could fill your house with Ford products, which brings us to today's topic. Here we've got a Philco Ford amplifier and speakers, and we're going to set it up and see how it sounds. With no model number, it's hard to pin this unit down to an exact year of manufacture, but it's likely to be from the very late 60s or the early 70s. There are four audio inputs for two pickups, a tuner and a cassette recorder, and typical of the time, use 5-pin DIN connectors. The speakers are hooked up using 2-pin DIN connectors. We're going to use a simple modern DVD player as a source, which will hook up with a lead that takes us from phono to 5-pin DIN. The pickup inputs are probably expecting a smaller input signal than the DVD player will give out, so I'm choosing to use the tape input for this. Okay, so we're ready to switch on. This unit hasn't been switched on for quite some time, so let's hope that that's okay. All seems okay, so now we just need to select tape and select stereo. I've set the volume down to minimum, just to start with, just to make sure that we don't overload the speakers at startup. So let's see how she sounds. It's sounding pretty good. There's a little distortion on the left speaker. Inside, there's just a single full-size EMI speaker, so it would benefit from a new one if it was possible to find a spare. But for now, it's good enough to properly install, so it can keep this 45 to 50 year old hi-fi in use. I hope you enjoyed the video.